You can see the sheets of rain covering the camera. So good run here from influential playmaker Lotoili, and on it went to Usuzuki, and he ran it in like a rabbit. Commentator's not okay.
We are very wet.
Commentator's soaking. I'm not sure about your audio mixer. It's going to...
So at half time, Japan Samurais leading 19 points to 7 over Sunnybank from Brisbane, Australia.
The water's coming through the cracks in the floor.
It is seeping through here like water through a Chuck Superwhite.
How are our bags, man? They're getting soaked.
Oh, yeah, they're soaked no matter what I do with either of them, unless we put them under the desk. What to do? I think we might put them under the desk. Might be half a chance.
Oh, I think we might have lost our feed.
Yeah, we've lost feed here.
We've lost the feed, the monitor. It's getting absolutely soaked. I think it might have blown. Do you want to put it? Get an engineer up here?
Well, this is an experience. One year it's a cyclone typhoon. One year it's... Might as well have an umbrella. Japan Samurais pinch the ball off the Sunnybank line out. Good run from Usuzuki. No, it's Murata. Come back on. Off the bench in the second half. Chance here for Japan Samurai. Sunnybank are up to the task in defence though. Very difficult conditions for both teams.
Good intercept there from the Sunnybank man, but the Japanese Kitagawa getting back well there. But it's still going, and the Sunnybank team have equalised here with a chance of taking the lead. That's great play from Kapua. We saw him in the first half too get a try or two. A very important kick here, and it's gone wide, so the scores remain tied at 19 points all.
We said it was going to be a close game at the beginning of this match, and that's what we've got. There's still some crowd here at the Padang watching a very good game of sevens in very, very difficult wet conditions. The pitch is holding up pretty well, Mike, considering.
You wouldn't know that about 2.5 months ago, They were having the National Day Parade here. The surface, the pitch was absolutely crushed. It was like a wrecking site, but they've done very well to lay the new turf down, root it in. As Japan try to take a quick line out. Referee wants to take it back, though.
Semba at the back. Number 9 for Japan, Samurai. Thought he was away.
That's untidy for Japan. A lot of pressure there from Sunnybank.
Atuliva trying to make something happen.
Forward pass there, so Sunnybank really got themselves into a position to win this game. That was very smart play from the Australian team. Don't forget, this is the club that Ben Gollings, the all-time point scorer in the IRB 7 circuit, went and played rugby for. So he's educated these young Australian guys in the games of sevens. And that was a great defensive line there, putting real pressure on the Japanese.
Yes, he's had a big influence over his Australian club. Just under 3 minutes to go. Good chance here. Free kick.
Ramovich takes it
to the left.
Step from Lee. Good working as well. Almost pick and roll stuff there from the Australian team. Three on one out wide, two. Get it out quickly. And they have just a step inside. He's lost the ball. 2 metres away from winning the game there. Just couldn't retain possession as he stepped off his left foot. Have to say, good defence there. Particularly
Narita.
Narita.
He was there in cover defence. Just knocks the ball loose. And just as well, because Montanabe was also there if he was required. Both teams showing a lot of energy, considering it's been a long day. 19-all, Japan Samurai, Sunnybank. A minute and a half to go. Japan Samurai working away from the try. Latuliva bashes his way into the Sunnybank defenders. Ususuki, nice little run. Away he goes, Yamauchi. Still. Japan Samurai ball, Yamauchi again. Watanabe. Atuliva can't handle. Tomigawa, is he playing advantage? Knock on.
Well, you'd hope that this Japanese squad have the fitness here to go into the last minute and win this game. They're a national squad. They played last weekend in the RB7 circuit, losing the final to Hong Kong. But you'd think fitness-wise they'd have more gas in the tank as we approach the last minute here. A real test for Tomoigawa, who puts the ball in, and his teammates.
It's all about taking chances. Japan Samurai under a lot of pressure there. Tomigawa.
Another set piece that goes awry.
Oh, very difficult to handle. Sunnybank defenders right on him.
Watanabe there, struggling along. Well, here's some space and here's some real gas from Usuzuki. He's away. Look at him go.
They won't catch him. They won't catch him. That's number 7. A great try in difficult conditions on their own try line. Emphatically, he puts the ball down. And that is the match winner.
That's what we were talking about, Justin. Sometimes a test like that is great for the character. And Japan have come through with flying colours. It was sloppy again from the set piece, but they managed somehow to wrap the ball up and then retain possession. And Usuzuki could see the path to the try line from about 80 metres out. And all he had to do was pin his ears back, and away he went.
More like 95, Mike. He was right there in front of the posts. A nice little shimmy, quick dummy. He was off. Sunnybank defence not up quick enough. And a great way to close a very good game.
Entertainment Plus, and it's the Japanese who come out victors in Pool D. Final score, 24-19 to the Samurais over Sunnybank.